Hello Windows Universe, in this video we will look at some Windows 11 settings you should change right away. For a more in-depth look at the topic, be sure to check out the article in the description. And let's get started. Sign in with a local account. If you want a computer experience without all of the background telemetry and tracking services, then we need to go to Settings, then Accounts, Your Info, and under Account Settings, you'll see Sign In with a Local Account instead. Click on it and follow any of the on-screen prompts to complete the process. Now let's look at turning off those annoying notifications. In Settings, go to System. Then look for Notifications. You'll see two boxes: Offer Suggestions on How I Can Set Up My Device, and Get Tips and Suggestions When I Use Windows. You'll want to uncheck both of those. Next, let's disable the annoying advertisements. For that, you'll go to Privacy and Security, go to the Windows Permissions section, and click on General. Turn off all of the boxes. Next, let's look at your default browser. If you use Microsoft Edge, you're in luck. That's the default browser in Windows 11. But if you use a different browser, one of the first things you should look at is changing your default browser. In Settings, go to Apps, go to Default Apps, look for Microsoft Edge, click on it, and as you see, you can set default types or link types. Change the ones that you want from Microsoft Edge to the default browser that you want set up. Even though you probably just upgraded to Windows 11, you need to check for updates. So, go down to Windows Updates, tell it to check for updates, then click on Download and Install, and then follow any of the on-screen prompts. Next, let's pin some of your favorites and most used programs to the Start menu and the taskbar, and remove ones that you don't need. We did a video just recently on how to do this in Windows 11, and we'll link it in the description. Let's now sync Clipboard across devices. This will allow you to share your clipboard between your PC and your smartphone. Go to System, then find Clipboard. On Sync Across Your Devices, toggle it on. You can now access your clipboard history on other supported devices. Just make sure that you've also downloaded and installed SwiftKey Beta on your phone. If you don't want videos automatically playing in the Microsoft Store, we can shut that off too. So, open the Microsoft Store. Then, click on your profile, go to App Settings, and look for Video Autoplay, and toggle it off. Windows 11 supports a higher refresh rate than Windows 10, so if your monitor can handle a refresh rate like 120, 144, or even 240 Hz, then we're going to go back into Settings, go to System, then look for Display. Look for refresh rate. Under Advanced Display, and under Choose Refresh Rate, set the refresh rate that you want. A higher refresh rate allows for a smoother transition, so if you're comfortable with it, take it as high as you possibly can. Let's look at some power settings now. By default, Windows 11 is set to a balanced power mode, but depending on your needs, we can change that. In Settings, go to System, then Power and Battery. Here, you could check between balanced, or you could check for a power saver one. I have mine in a high performance power plan, so I don't have the ability to change that. This next recommended setting is more a recommended setting if you share the system with an elderly person or a teen. It protects your system from having a malicious app downloaded to it. Go to Apps, then go to Apps and Features. You'll see Choose Where's to Get Apps. You have options between anywhere. Anywhere but let me know if there's a comparable app in the Microsoft Store. Anywhere but warn me before installing an app that's not from the Microsoft Store and the Microsoft Store only recommended. If you share the computer with someone who's an elderly person or a teen and you want to make sure that no malicious app is downloaded in your computer, set this to Microsoft Store only. For more helpful articles to help you maximize your Windows experience, go to our website, thewindowsclub.com. Do not forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel, where we are always adding new content aimed at making you the master of your digital house. Thanks for watching and have a great day.